What's up, guys? We're here at AMC Town Square with Chasing Cinema.
Mr. James Shute.
.com. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And we're here for a movie that I don't even know if it's available for me to watch in Vegas.
Yeah, I don't know either. But whenever this is free, if it's available, if you're watching this review, that means the movie's available.
Kyler Ray Jepsen would say, call me maybe.
Yes, but this movie is Call Me By Your Name.
Oh, okay.
So a little bit different, starring Armie Hammer and Timothy Chalamet. Hopefully, Chalamet. I'm not butchering that name. Saw this actor a little earlier in this year. In Lady Bird, he plays a character kind of similar to the one he plays in this movie. In 1983,
I was 1 year old.
Oh, nice. This
you weren't even born.
No, it was not even a gleam in my mother's eyes, as they would say. 1983 in the summer, in Italy. A young 17-year-old boy is with his family, and they decide. His dad, who is a professor, takes an Armie Hammer, who is a graduate student, and they're studying all these great things. And during this summer, this relationship kind of starts between Armie Hammer, who is an older gentleman, and the 17-year-old Timothy Chalamet.
What does he play, Armie Hammer? Like 35, 30?
He plays probably 30s, okay. Early 30s. This is a movie that's getting a lot of praise right now. I believe right now, at the moment we're filming this, it's at a 98%. A lot of talk for supporting actor, best actor, picture, as well as director. And I think all of these things are quite true, because I really enjoyed this movie. It's interesting though, right now the controversy around this movie, though it's not so much around critics, because critics really accepted this movie, is that Hollywood right now is fighting back against,
the Harvey Weinstein,
sexual assault and all this thing,
Kevin Spacey's,
and the pedophilia, yet we're watching a movie in which a 30-year-old man is falling in love with a 17-year-old, which I think is a bit of a stretch difference of like how everything turns out and things like that. And I think the movie is not trying to exploit children or is trying to be, talk about this sexual harassment or anything like that. I think it is about a young boy who is trying to figure out who he is and what he wants and all of these things. And yes, though he's under the age of 18, I don't think it's like that much of a jump to, though I don't want to get political here and get in that conversation. But then again, I think that's the major difference in people who like this movie and didn't like this movie. I think here, your two things you really got to focus on are Armie Hammer and Timothy Chalamet. I mean, the performances here are so good and raw and filled with emotions. One of the most sexually charged movies I think I've seen this year. I mean, just a movie that is full of sexual tension. I mean, every scene, and it kind of comes off, these two characters who meet, they really don't have this chemistry at all, and then it doesn't take any time for that just to kind of be there and build. And while it is this movie, I think, that really focuses on sex and lust and more of love of the body than is the heart, I think there becomes this really beautiful relationship between these two characters that is exploring this idea of wrong time, wrong place, and there's a lot of questioning. I mean, it's definitely a coming of age story that takes it to a much deeper level about a boy who's just trying to explore and find out who he is and finds himself through Armie Hammer. And though Armie Hammer isn't necessarily available to him, he kind of finds out the path where he will follow for the rest of his life. And I think all of that are quite really charming things. I mean, I think the script here is really good as far as screenplay. Armie Hammer is good, but I think your star is the star of the movie, Timothy Chalamet, who's just really, really good. And just every scene is just kind of really radiating some emotion, whether it be good or bad. And I was surprised how much I really got into this movie, not because of the content, but just because love movies always tend to fall a little shy on me, and I just saw this movie in a double feature with Shape of the Water, a movie that we reviewed recently, which is another love story of sort, nor near as complex as this one is. Surprisingly, this movie about two males in Italy falling in love is even more complex and even harder to understand. It has far more emotion than the relationship between Shape of the Water, which is about a woman and a creature. But I think there's a lot of heart here, and there's a lot of just really soul-searching that goes on in that movie, and I think you could feel that through. And I think cinematography-wise, the movie's beautiful, and I think it really kind of embraces the 80s without being in your face, too, which I think is a really important element of the movie, because time is a big factor in, you know, homosexuality in Europe and things like that. So, a movie you're interested in seeing at all?
Yeah, potentially.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't even know if I can watch it.
I believe it opens here. If you're watching this, it should be available. I believe this is in January. Yeah. Yes, I don't believe this is in December when we're filming this, but I don't know how many theaters it'll open up here. It'll probably get some more love once the Oscars come around.
Yeah, if the nominations are there, that'll help.
We'll start seeing circling through. A movie I definitely think that's worth seeing, and I think that that does have some really good emotion and some really good meaning in there that I think people will enjoy.
Insidious 4 does nothing for me, so if it's already available, I'll watch this.
Instead of Insidious Last Key.
No, I'll still watch it, I'm just saying.
Yeah, that first
one. I like to watch 2 movies a week.
I don't blame you.
Yeah.
But depending on when this movie comes out, we have also reviewed a ton of stuff lately. We reviewed The Greatest Showman, we reviewed Jumanji, Star Wars Last Jedi. Maybe if you're watching this after Christmas, we could have reviewed The Post. We could have reviewed Downsizing, we reviewed.
Matt Damon.
There's a bunch of stuff we reviewed. So make sure to just always keep following Chasing Cinema. And then, again, I don't know if you'll be watching this after, but we'll be filming our top 10 at the end of December. It'll come out January 1st. You might see that first before you see this. But either way, make sure to follow along and you'll see plenty of reviews well into 2018.
Credits to Kent Wong.
Kent Wong is the man. Appreciate him every time taking time out of his life to record all of these videos and listen to us rant and talk about movies. It is always a great thing. We appreciate him for. Mrs. Shu, after 6 years of watching movies with you, it's never gotten old. It's always been fun.
Always. Let's go for really 12.
Let's do it. Two more years, or twice, double it.
I doubled it.
Yeah. 12 years, huh? I wonder who'll be dominating the Oscar race in 12 years.
Star Wars will still be there.
Yeah, maybe.
All right, ChasingCinema.com is known as
Film Lovers Web. Happy holidays, guys.